Hello guys, and this is the Russian Genius, and in this video I will be showing you an awesome card trick which is for beginners and also for advanced. I will be showing you the beginner version and also the advanced version, and I will be focusing mostly on the beginner version of this trick. So let me show you how the advanced version looks like, and then I will show you the beginner version. For this we are going to need the two queens, the Queen of Hearts and the Queen of Diamonds, and also a card selected. It can be any card inside the deck. Let's say we pick this one, which in this case is the Ace of Clubs. So quite easy to remember, Ace of Clubs. It can be any card in the deck, but in this case it's the Ace of Clubs. So right now we have the two queens and the Ace of Clubs as the selection. Now the two queens, they are going to find the card which we selected, and here's how it's going to look like. I am gonna be placing one of the queens on top of the deck and the other queen on the bottom, just like this, and I'm gonna snap my fingers, throw the deck to my hand, and then one card is going to appear between the two queens. So look, just like that, one card in between the two queens, and we picked the Ace of Clubs. Let's take a look. This is the Ace of Clubs. That was the advanced version, and here is how the beginner version it looks like. The beginner version is much easier, and here's how it looks like. So for this we are going to need the two queens. So let's just use the black queens this time, but it can be the red queens once again, but in this case I will just be using the two black queens. Place it on the table, and we are going to be using them in a moment. So we need any card selected, so let's just give the deck a few more cuts before we do so, and the spectator can shuffle up the deck if they want to. So any card is selected, let's say it's this one, and this is the Four of Diamonds. So out of all the cards, the spectator, or we in this case, selected the Four of Diamonds, as you can see. Now basically what's gonna happen is that the four is going to be going inside the center. We are gonna shuffle it, and this is once again the beginner version, so just like this. And let's give the deck a overhand shuffle as well, just like that. And now the two queens, they're going to find the selection. So as you can see, one queen goes on top, one queen goes on the bottom. Once again, snap my fingers, throw the deck, one card is in between those two cards, and this is the Four of Diamonds which we selected. So that was the beginner version, and let's just move on to the tutorial. This is quite simple to do. I will first show you how the advanced version is done, and then I will teach you the beginner version. So for the advanced version, you take out two cards, like the two queens, any two cards you want, and you are simply going to do the top shot once the cards, they are, you know, facing each other on top of the deck. So you do the top shot like this, you catch it, you place it on top of the deck or on the table, you can decide. You take any card from the deck, let's say the Nine of Hearts, and I show the bottom card because this will make the trick more exciting, so the spectator, they remember the Nine of Hearts, and then I simply control the selection to the second from the bottom by using the straddle pass control. Then I take the two queens, so one, two, and I show the bottom card while displaying the two queens, and then I do the clip shift, which looks something like this. Clip shifted on top, place the queen on top, the other queen on the bottom, and now when I throw it, my fingers, they're taking the card just like that. So anyways, that's the advanced version, and let's move on to the beginner version, which I'm going to go more in depth into. So the beginner version is much easier. You just take the two queens, you produce them however you like, just like this, and you place them on the table. And the reason for that is because I want the spectator to, you know, give the deck few shuffles and stuff like that. So once it's shuffled, you take any card you like. Let's for this use a card that we easily can remember. So let's just use the Ace of Spades. Let's say that the spectator picked the Ace of Spades, and for this tutorial I'm using the Ace of Spades because it's easier to remember. Here's what I do. I take the Ace of Spades, the selection that they chose, and I place it on the bottom and flip over the deck, because I'm gonna be using a very easy control that is for beginners and also for advanced people. The control looks like this. You're going to do a double lift, so like this. Right now you are at the bottom of the deck, and you do the pinky count, two cards, and then you're going to do the Stuart Gordon double lift while flipping over the deck. If that is too difficult, then you can do this. You can simply talk to the spectator and then say, you picked the Ace of Spades, it could have been any card in this deck, and then just quickly get a pinky break below the top two cards without them seeing it. You can either just do this and then get a pinky break without the spectator seeing it, or you can just push them over as a double and then get a pinky break. Once you have the break, then you are going to do any double lift you want. I'm doing the Stuart Gordon double lift and then a deck flip, which is the Murphy's 180 or whatever it's called. I don't really remember the name of it. If you cannot do it, then just do the Stuart Gordon double and place it on the bottom and then flip it over with the hand, which is also possible to do. If you cannot do that, then just take it like this and then flip it over by using your index finger and then place it on top. When it's on top, you're gonna complete the double however you like, and then just simply place it in the center, give it a few shuffles like this, and once it's on top of the deck, then you're going to control it to the bottom by simply using the overhand shuffle. So you take one card and then the rest goes on top, and now it's on the bottom. And now I take, you know, the two queens which are laying on the table, Queen of Diamonds and the Queen of Hearts, place the Queen of Diamonds on top, place the Queen of Hearts on the bottom without flashing this card, of course, just like this. And the Queen of Hearts, the bottom queen, is going to get sidejocked, and the Queen of Diamonds is just going to be on top. These fingers, they're going to be touching the card which is on the bottom of the deck above the queen, and the Queen of Diamonds is going to get held by the thumb. So the top card by the thumb, and the second card from the bottom, the selection, is going to get held by the index, middle and ring finger, and the pinky is just, you know, laying on top on the bottom of the deck. Now when you throw the deck, you're going to let go a little bit, so just like this, as you can see. And when you let go, then all the cards fall down except for these three cards, and then this one card is trapped in the center, and that is of course the Ace of Spades, which we selected. Now I'm going to quickly show you the advanced version and then the beginner version once again. So the beginner version is once again like this. You have two queens, place them on the table, and then any card in the deck gets selected. Let's say it's this one, for instance, which in this case is the three of diamonds. So the three of diamonds is the card that we selected out of all these cards. It could have been any card in the deck, but in this case it is the three of diamonds. So look, it's gonna be going inside the center like this, gonna give it a quick shuffle, and also one of these shuffles, just like that. Oops, just like that. And the two queens right here on the table, they're going to find your card. I'm just going to sandwich the deck and then snap the fingers, throw it like this, and one card in between the two queens, and that is the three of diamonds that we selected. So that was the beginner version, and here is the advanced version. Why am I stuttering every time I say beginner or advanced? That's weird. So the advanced version is, you know, fun to do, fun to practice, and it's because it can be a little bit difficult for some magicians that are not specifically advanced with a deck of cards. So once again, just like that, two queens on top of the deck. We also need a selection. Let's say it's this one. The Ace of Clubs, once again, like in the intro of the video. So the Ace of Clubs is going to be going inside the center of the deck, and the two queens, they're going to be finding the Ace of Clubs, the card which you selected or which we selected. So once again, just like that, one card in between, and that is the Ace of Clubs. I will do the advanced version last time, but this time I will be flashing everything so you can see it. So just like that, two queens, we select a card, six of spades in this case. So the six of spades is going to be going inside the center of the deck, just like that. And the two queens, they are going to find your selection, which is the six of spades. So then I do this move, place the two queens right there, there is the six, snap the fingers, and just like that. So anyways, that was what I wanted to show you. This is fun to practice and fun to perform, fun to show for other magicians, because this does involve some difficult slides. For instance, the clip shift, where you are taking the card to the top and then you are covering the move by using the queens, or that's what I like to do. So I cover the move by using the queens when the card comes on top, just like that. And it's a fun thing to practice. If you're a beginner, then I would recommend showing this to your friends, because it impresses a lot of people and it's fun to do. It's an amazing trick for beginners. So thank you for watching, and if you have not subscribed, then feel free to do so. There is going to be a lot of whoa, did you see that? It just flew out of the deck. There's going to be a lot of more awesome content in the future. Thank you guys for watching. I really hope that you enjoy my tutorial on this move, and as always, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Honestly, why do I feel like this? So sick, surrounded by a wall of bricks, tall and stiff, they're closing in, makes me wanna jump out of my fucking skin. But I'm frozen to the floor and I can't even open the oaken door. So it's like I've been getting success, but I need a bit more. Been meeting my fans, which I'm grateful for, scripting the plans, listening for shows. I know I chose to grow up.